हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम जस्ट गोना लेट यू गो थ्रू सम चोर्स दैट यू हैव टू डू टू कलेक्ट सम स्टफ। लाइक फर्स्ट आई एम गोना शो यू अनडेड ट्रेडर। सो दीज यू कैन कलेक्ट डेली, दीज रिसोर्सेज ऑफ पर्पल बैग ऑफ आयरन एंड सिल्वर एंड ब्लू बैग ऑफ फूड एंड फूड। नाउ इंस्पायर, इफ यू आर SH 40 और अबव देन these two should go. Match capacity booster that I select early, and if you are not maxed out on your artifacts, these should go. And since if you are going for SH 40, then noble badges also. And since I need banners right now, so I'm gonna collect banners also. Okay. My dragon is not maxed out on this account, so I will be collecting pile of meat and super dragon skills once I reset my spire. And in trial shop, I don't need to collect this oracle statue because I'm maxed out on that. So I'm gonna collect speeds. So collect all the speeds daily, as much as you can, as many as you can. And this is hero experience that you should collect. And these dragon crystals that should not go unattended. Let's do some gemstones. After the upgrade event, there must be some points available there. So let's see how many can we get here. Okay, so I got 15,000 more coins. So I got 27 spare coins. So what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna buy 20,000 statue material. Now this is you should collect daily, and this Royal Arena. You should keep on playing that because it gives resources and other stuff as well. Whatever you get in this game for free, you should not avoid it just because it is very low in quantity or whatever it is. That's free is free. If you don't collect it, you're not gonna get it. If you collect it, you'll get it, and it will be up for benefit, nothing else. Let's see. Let's see this dude, how strong is he? Okay, not much strong. Okay, let's try to change dragon skills. I'll show you my dragon skills also, that how a free player or non-spender should assign dragon skills and everything. Let's see how many attempts I should be able to kill it. He has only 60,000 more troops. I'm doing more damage killing lesser. That's because of heroes, I guess. And tire matters. Okay, now I'm gonna show you my draconic stones. See, I'm a free player or non-spender, you can say. So if, as you can see, I have three talents. First talent is for only basically red crystals, red stones, one blue stone and one green stone. So this will unlock your these talents. Now for this level 4, level 5 needed a lot point. Yeah, level 5 needs 300. So only LV3 crystals will get us there. So forget that, LV4 would do. So pretty much maxed out on combat skills. So no worries. Now second skill is for the default skill that will give you, see, LV2 is just for from barbarians, and LV3 chest that again gonna cost you 300, so forget that part. So LV2 chest would do also. This much is construction, food, wood, iron cost and food cost, so you're gonna basically get something. It's not much, but it is something, so anything is worth it. And this is what is this? Resources gathering speed, okay. And this is production speed, and so extra 15% production speed. Now third skill would be for construction benefits and training benefits. So as you can see, construction benefit, and this is speed construction, and this is research speed, and this is training speed. For training speed, another you need 360 and 120, so forget it. That will be done from LV3 crystals only. And now this is you can get Dragoni chest LV1, LV2 and LV3, so for 80 and 200. So once you get there, it's okay, go for there. So by default you can select your slot 2 skills talent for dragon, so that you can collect from barbarians, and you do not forget that. And whenever you have Nether War or UAC or any war or KVK, don't forget to switch it to first talent. This is your war talent, this is your barbarian talent, and this is your special talent for construction or research or training. Okay, so and let me go through more, and don't forget to collect these resources. Since you're in alliance, you get them for free, and daily you can collect like 1.5. I can collect 1.5 million across my all farms, and another a million or 1.5 million I produce, and then I do lot talent of gather that gives me like this instant gather, yeah. Instant yield gives me another like 400,000, 900,000, and this gives me around 200 to 500k, half a million approximately daily. So that much you can get around 4 to 5 million across your all farms, and you don't train much in farms. So daily if you get 4 million food, so in 28 days it would be like 110 million food without doing anything much, just you collecting your resources. Okay, so this way you will be able to do some good stuff. We had some Netherfall, so even that, okay, forget that part. So these are chores I wanted to tell you. Let go through again. Okay, this is done. Yeah, one more thing, that since this is not my main bigger account, so I'm gonna collect this. To collect these accolades once every week, and for that you have to skip this march speed once or twice in a week. Daily collect resources of last 4, then collect this march speed daily too. But whenever you're gonna take accolades in a week, then you have to skip these march speeds twice in a week, so you can collect only 5 times in a week. So that would be 10. That would be enough. If you are a non-spender, it's okay, you have to compromise on some things, so don't bother about that. And what I else can help you with? Just give me a minute. Okay, that's it, that's all. There's nothing much to tell now, so I hope this will help you. Yeah, sorry, I forgot formation. Your first formation is for, likewise right now I have infantry, so once I get what, let's say my Kiara and lot, so then I will assign bowman march. So cavalry and bowman march, all both are same, because 40% infantry and 40% bowman I have assigned in this, and 20% cavalry. So this is my infantry oblique bowman march, and this is my cavalry march, in which I'm missing Gunnivar. So once I get Gunnivar, I'll be assigning 40% cavalry, 40% infantry, and 20% bowman. So my first march is infantry oblique bow, second march is cavalry, third march is my golem march, and these two are golem heroes. Fourth march I use generally, this is not golem march, this is for barbarian rallies or something like you do. Right now we have Yetis, and then Ravager, whatever, and Alliance Hunt. And if you go in Firelands, if you need bigger march than cavalry just to defend against small guys, then you can send these march. And fifth march, I guess I assigned for gathering, and sixth I haven't assigned because I'm working on it, and that should be your reinforcement march. So reinforcement type depends if it is infantry bow or cavalry. So you have to assign 5 and 6, and let's say 5 is infantry bow and 6th is cavalry march. So you can do like that if you are in Netherfall or in KVK, so you like to assign some number of troops there. So let's say someone asking 300 or 400,000 troops, then you just send them by tapping and sending. You do not need particular heroes. Like if I'm sending for cavalry, let's say I'm selecting Lancelot and Ygritte. That's it. And then select your dragon because you're sending them. Now your march cap is increased. And assign whatever you can. So right now I'm saving it. Okay. So I hope this will help you. So keep upgrading and keep becoming beast. Okay. Thank you.